Today, learn how to make hyper-realistic fur in under 15 minutes. And trust me when I say it's a whole lot easier than you think. And sponsoring today's video is Skillshare, the place to learn a new skill set heading into 2020. With classes on music, photography, design, freelancing, and much, much more, there's bound to be something there to trigger your creativity and something that can provide vital skills. Learn more about how to grab a Skillshare premium membership later in today's video. Now, next week, I have a video coming out about the future of graphic design. And in that video, one huge part of the future in this industry is going to be 3D design. So Blender is free to download. And with my step-by-step method, you will learn something awesome in today's video. So let's get cracking. And in Blender, press Shift and A, which is the command to add something. And let's grab a UV sphere. Now turn on the shortcut of UUR. And don't worry about these icons here, your screen should probably only have around about 3. But for now, come into the Renders Properties menu here, and make sure you are in the Cycles Render Engine. Now the Cycles Engine is going to be more simple for this kind of 3D realistic fur today. Although, however, the Cycles Render might slow down your machine. So let's move the render down to 12, and also the viewpoint to 1. You could max them out to around 24 and 12, but for the example today, let's just stick with this. So with the sphere selected, come down to where it says particles, and we're going to add a new particle system like so. So this is my particle system, and yours will probably have a different value attached to it. But just be concerned about coming down here and pressing hair. And this is going to offer us a really basic starting point with the fur or the hair for our design. So from here, check the advanced box and then come down to where it says source. And then we want to emit from volume here in this box on the right. This is going to add some more randomness to the length of the hair, as you can see here. You can also do something like turning off the even distribution. But I think it's probably going to look better if we keep that checked today. We can also come down to the velocity menu and make things a bit more random by cycling the randomizer here. This is going to be subjective to your style and your design, of course. So now look down to physics, forces, and in the Brownian menu. And this is going to let us twist our hair a little bit, and it's going to make things look unruly or kind of unkept if you're talking about a hairstyle. But let's go ahead and give it a slight, modest twist. And again, this is going to add some interest to our design. Also up here in the emissions menu, we can change the length of the hair itself. Again, this is totally going to be subjective. So now come down to viewpoint display and also to the strand steps. The more steps you add, the more kind of kinks and curves there will be in each strand of hair. And if you do jack this number up, it's going to slow your computer even more so. So just be aware of that. So for today's fur design, come down to children and we're going to use the interpolated option. And this is really going to fill out our hair. So we've kind of got a snow white sphere of hair at the moment, but we want to add some color. The actual style of the hair is far from finished, but let's just add some color at this point in the tutorial. And to add color, we need to come down to the material properties menu here. And we're going to add a new material and give it a name relevant, something like hair color. So now come up to the shader workspace and let's turn off our viewpoint. All I did there was change my viewport shading to be material preview. You can navigate out of the camera by clicking this button here, or you can use a middle mouse button if you do have one. So to add the color, come down to the UI here and kind of hover your mouse around in the left-hand side and then press that Shift-A command to add something. And we're going to add a texture which is going to drive two colors into our design. So give a search of Muzz Grave and you should just type in MUS and it should appear up in the box. So drag the height value into the base color, and that should give you a kind of black and white look as of now. Now the contrast between the black and the white is too stark for my liking, so we can bring down the detail, which will smoothen out the contrast between those two colors. Again, this is going to be subjective to your design, but I like to have it just above zero, to be honest. And of course, you can play with these other settings too for your design. But now, press Shift A again, and give a search for a color ramp. And with a click held down on your mouse, drag this color ramp around until you see this white line illuminate brightly, and then release the click. And so now you should have some more control over the colors of the fur seen up here. For your design, you want to pick two colors that you think will work well together and will have a kind of interesting blend. And if you've seen the movie Monsters, Inc., I'm kind of going for something similar to Sully in a way. And you could use more than two colors, of course, but we're just going to use two for now. So for my design, I'm going to go for a kind of pinky, purpley kind of approach. The aim of the game in this section of the video is to kind of balance your colors and spend time really finding that nice contrast between everything going on. You can also come over back to the detail section and, you know, reset things a little bit if it's not showing up properly in terms of the contrast. What we need to do next is to position the camera that will resemble or give focus to the final render. So grab the camera and then go into the camera mode, and then press N on your keyboard and come into view. We're going to want to lock the camera to the view, and then you can just zoom in or out as you would with a mouse button. Once you're happy with the view, and do make sure you're happy with it, uncheck the camera view lock button. Remember, you can also use this button over here to come out of the camera view. We are not finished yet, of course, but let's give this a test render very quickly. Oh, another thing that I should note is that under the denoising menu, you want to check the render denoise. So let's press F12 and let's give this a render, and you can see the progress bar down here in the bottom right. Let's check the render progress up here, and we are getting a pretty nice render actually. We have two different colors going on, and we've got some detail in the kind of strands of the fur, but we can enhance this further, and we're going to do that by playing with lighting values. Lighting values are very crucial for 3D design, and especially for things like 3D fur. So let's come back to the layer first. We already have a sun lamp right here, but let's remove that. Press Shift A again for that command to add something, and then navigate to light, and then let's grab a sun. Yeah, raise it up a little bit and then move it around so it's pointing towards the object. If you want to see the true result of the lighting, you have to come up to Viewport Shading, and that's going to show you the result of the lighting. Another way you can change the lighting in Blender for this design would be coming over to the Environment Texture, and we can change the world color here. This is going to add a bit of ambience to the whole scene, and I'm going to add a little bit of blue light. So with the light selected, I can come into the data properties here, and I'm going to choose a bit of an orange hue, which is kind of complementary to the blue world color. And that will add some interest to your final render. So let's jump into the camera view and see what it's looking like. And of course, on screen, this isn't the proper render and how it's going to finally look. We can increase the light strength here, and I'm going to do that by a factor of 25. 25 is pretty over the top, so let's drag it down to something like 5. And there you go, that's looking really nice and crisp around the edges especially. Again, this is something you probably want to play around with in your own time, and it's something that can really make or break your design. What I can actually do again is duplicate this sun, and that's with Shift and D, and then I'm going to use the move tool to actually move it to a different position. Yes, the real world doesn't have two suns, but I want to get a kind of backlight which is going to, you know, illuminate different parts of my design in more interesting ways. I'm going to point this new duplicated sun kind of into the camera itself. And to add some more contrast in the lighting, let's, you know, reduce the strength of this one down to about 1 or something around there. Also, changing the color ever so slightly will help as well with the final effect. But let's go ahead and add a third light, and that's going to be a point light, and use that keyboard shortcut of Shift and A. Point lights are really good for adding a kind of focal point or highlight onto an object. I'm going to jack up the power here to about 1000, which will overblow it, but then I could change the radius, which will soften that light. You also want to play around with the positioning of this point light as well. If we change the color of the point light, the hair is going to pick up that color in kind of interesting ways. So let's go for a bit of a blue tone today. So you can press function 12 to render, or you could just come up here at the top. And now that render is looking a lot more complex, more interesting, and also more detailed. So like I said, graphic design is moving into interesting areas, and in the next 2, 5, 10 years, 3D design and 3D animation as well is going to be a huge part of what makes up this industry. If we fail to adapt, we're not going to succeed in this career. And yes, 2D design is still going to be relevant, but I think if you can learn 3D design, you've got another skill set under your belt. Making today's video possible is Skillshare. It's the online learning community where millions of creatives come together to learn new skills and to excel their careers or their hobbies into 2020. I'm actually learning how to create 3D and 4D animations through Skillshare, so it's really easy to integrate Skillshare into your day-to-day life. And you guys will probably see some tutorials around 3 or 4D animations on this channel when I do perfect and master those skills. It's something I've wanted to learn for a long time, but I've never really had the time to do it. Now you can grab a premium membership to Skillshare for a limited time as a free trial, and that's going to lead you to learning a new skill set in your desired field. So join Skillshare today and learn some new essential skills for your career or your hobby heading into 2020. So I hope you enjoyed today's video, and I hope you enjoyed making this 3D fur design. Let me know if you want to see more tutorials in Blender and what you'd like to see. But until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.